and not cursed. We have inherited that same rank and position. He's on the right hand of God. Now we have inherited that same position. We are on the right hand of God because we are in Christ Jesus, seated with Christ, check that, in heavenly places. That's where our spirit is. We are seated with Christ in heavenly places. Christ is seated on the right hand of God. That's where we are, on the right hand of God. That's how close you are to the Father.
Amen.
Don't let your situation blind you from your help. Don't let your circumstances or the cares and affairs of this life blind you from seeing the myriad of angels that are at your beck and call. The Bible says the angel of the Lord encamp around about those that fear them and delivereth them. That means you have a special angel that follows you everywhere you go for your protection. Don't lose sight of that angel you have as you go through these circumstances. They will make you forget that you got angelic help. These problems will make you forget that you're on the right hand of God. And you will start to operate from the flesh instead of call on your help in the spirit. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And so you have to realize that you have a myriad of angels that you can call at any point in time. And they will be there on assignment. They've been assigned to you to deliver you. They've been assigned to you to help you. They've been assigned to you to bring you wealth, to bring you a prosperity, to bring you openings and advantages and assets so you can be what God has called you to be down here. They're ministering spirits.
Yes, amen.
Sent from heaven to the heirs of salvation, which is us, because we're sons and daughters of God, joint heirs with Christ. The same angels that ministered to Christ when he was on the mount of temptation, after Satan and him had that confrontation, angels came to minister to Christ after he went through a trial. There's angels waiting to minister to you if you recognize them and not be blinded but for what's in front of you and what you're going through. Give God some more hand praise on that. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And so your affections allow you to reach past, you know, the physical and tap into the spiritual and understand where you're at. And also help you recognize when God has left. Because you need to know when God is not leading you in an area and you're on your own. Yeah, you have to know. One way that you can know God is leading you is you will have a sense of peace on the inside in your decision. If God wants you to wait, or is saying this is not it, you're gonna have a whole bunch of questions. A whole bunch of flags might pop up. Things might get a little out of hand. Now in that also, just because things look chaotic doesn't mean that God is not in it, okay? Doesn't mean that he's not trying to move you to another realm, because the minute you start making gains in God, Satan is gonna start throwing stumbling blocks to make you fall. He's gonna try to make it seem like this is not the will of God for you. And you can see that in a lot of people when they're just trying to come to church. A lot of stumbling blocks, phone calls, things begin to happen, traffic jams, accidents, just out of nowhere. Traffic's flowing all day, flowing good. All of a sudden, you want to come to church. Things happen, problems, light too long. Light goes out, it's blinking red all of a sudden. Cars backed up. Amen, praise God. Somebody just taking their time across the road, just walking and looking. You're like, just get over on the other side, man.
Yeah.
You ain't that important. My God, pull your pants up while you're doing it. Well, pay attention. Get off the phone. Something. Hallelujah. Something to come to distract you and slow you down from making it to your destination. Amen. So you want to stay in tune with those kind of things, your affections. The next thing is called reason. The next gate is called reason. Reason is connected to your taste gate. Okay? Reason is connected to your taste gate. It allows you to determine what's good and what's bad. What tastes good and what tastes bad. It allows you to discover the flavor of a thing, to see if it's good for digestion. Okay? This is what your reasoning faculty is for. It allows your soul to determine if what a person's saying is good or bad. The Bible says, taste and see how good God is. So Christ is a master of the culinary arts. He's a master of the culinary arts. He alone has the ability to take things that don't look good, don't taste good, look like it can't be used, put it all in his mixing bowl, and turn it all good. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes, he will.
Hallelujah. Yeah.